How's everybody doing? Today I have a Blu-ray Steelbook update, and I have three Blu-ray Steelbooks today. First up is the Men in Black Blu-ray Steelbook from Germany. Of course, it has that little rating sticker right there. I don't know if this can be peeled off or not. It looks like it can be, but I'm not going to mess with it, just in case the adhesive gets all on there or it gets hard to do. So I'm going to leave that on there. But if you have taken this off before and you think it's easy to do, please let me know. Or if you have a way to do it, you have like rubbing alcohol, any kind of tips or techniques that you do, let me know. But I was souped to get this. I love the movie. I love Men in Black 1 and 2, and they're making the third one. There was all in the news recently that Will Smith had like a 58-foot trailer, and it was like an absorbent amount of money, like $2 million or something crazy like that, or like a luxury trailer. And people were complaining that it was taking too much room on the street, and so there's a whole big ordeal about it on the news. And I think it was just blown out of proportion personally, but Will Smith decided to get rid of the trailer. I personally like Will Smith as an actor. I know a lot of people don't. To each their own. However, I am looking forward to Men in Black 3. Again, I enjoyed the first two. Let me know what you think of the Men in Black movies, and if you're looking forward to the third one. But the Steelbook is awesome, and there's a ton of special features on this one. You can see Will Smith and Tommy Lee Jones on the cover right there, and there's the spine. You can see Frank the Pug right there on the spine, and there's the back. Very glossy feel to the cover, a nice sheen to it. And you open it up and there's the disc, and there is some inside artwork right there. And you take out the disc and that's what it looks like right there. A little Blu-ray advertisement. I do appreciate the inside artwork, very cool. I love Steelbooks in general, and especially Blu-ray Steelbooks, and this was a very cool edition to pick up. Very happy to have it in my collection. And next up is the Deluxe Unrated Salt Blu-ray Steelbook. This is a Best Buy exclusive. And it's three versions of the film, the theatrical cut, plus two unrated extended cuts. So that is a lot of versions of this film. I have not seen this film yet personally. Heard a lot of great things about it. I heard it was like a female Born Identity movie. So if you've seen the movie, let me know what you think of it. And I'm gonna open this baby up right now. The inaugural christening right there, opening this up. And there we go. And of course it has this little paper backing right here. I'm gonna peel this off nice and gently with love. Oh yeah, baby. And that's nice, no adhesive residue. I appreciate that. This does include a digital copy as well, and a ton of special features on here. And there's Angelina Jolie on the back. And I love the cover to this. Very haunting kind of picture, with her eyes just looking right at you. Look at that gaze. Very nice, sleek looking cover. Again, it's very glossy and very nice feel to it, nice sheen. And there's salt on the spine right there. And it's only one disc. I thought there would be like two or three discs, but there's only one disc. And there's the inside artwork. Nothing really behind here where the disc was, but right there. There's a little Sony 3D ad in there. I haven't seen the movie, so I'm looking forward to it. Hopefully it'll be pretty good. I've heard great things about it. And next up is the Australian release of Edge of Darkness, Blu-ray Steelbook right there with Mel Gibson. Everybody's hating on Mel Gibson. You know what, I still like him as an actor and as a director. Apocalypto was amazing in my opinion. Sometimes it's hard for people to separate the actor or director from the actual movies, like Roman Polanski, things that he's done, Woody Allen even, and of course Victor Salva, but I love Jeepers Creepers, and of course Roman Polanski and Woody Allen are legends. But sometimes it's hard for people to separate what they've done in their personal life from their movies. And Mel Gibson, thank goodness for Charlie Sheen, right Mel Gibson? Otherwise he'd be in the news all the time if it wasn't for Charlie Sheen. I think Mel Gibson owes Charlie Sheen a drink for helping bring the media spotlight off of him. But I haven't seen this one either. I'm looking forward to it. This is a region-free Blu-ray Steelbook. Edge of Darkness right there on the spine. And I love the back of this. The Boston PD badge right there. That is just a really cool, sleek design right there. This is a matte finish on this Blu-ray Steelbook. I've heard a lot of people compare this to Taken. I know everybody loved Taken, but I wasn't really a huge fan of Taken. I thought it was good, but not great. That's just me personally. I just thought it was a little too far-fetched and over the top. But I did enjoy it. I just didn't like it as much as everybody else seemed to. Right there. There's the disc, and really again, there's no artwork really behind the disc, but there's that inside artwork there, which again, I love and appreciate that all of these Blu-ray Steelbooks are having the inside artwork. I love inside artwork. It's just that little something extra that makes you really happy with the overall presentation. And this is a beautiful Steelbook, happy to add it to my collection. I love all these ones. I just love when things are so sleek and stylish like that. And actually, all three of these Blu-ray Steelbooks are region-free. So there you go, those are my three Blu-ray Steelbooks that I picked up. Let me know what you guys think of them, and let me know what you guys think of the movies if you've seen them as well. Hope everybody's doing well. Take care.